What's up, everyone? Sam here from ByteByByte.com, and today I want to give you a framework for how you can approach your data structures and algorithms for your coding interview so that you can go into your interview and absolutely crush it. All right, so in this video, as I mentioned, I want to give you a specific framework for preparing for your data structures and algorithms for your interview. And this is so, so important, right? Because at the end of the day, all of your interview ability comes down to how well you understand the fundamentals. Particularly, let's say you went to a boot camp or you learned this stuff on your own and you don't have that background. This is incredibly important because by understanding the core fundamentals, it's going to allow you to really problem solve in your interview. No matter how many strategies you practice, no matter how many strategies you learn, no matter how many, you know, practice problems you go through, it all comes back to that core, those core data structures and algorithms. That's really where you're gonna have the most success when you're interviewing. If you have those fundamentals down cold, you can go into your interview and be confident, right? You can go into your interview knowing that you like know your stuff, and that even if you see a problem that you haven't seen before, even if you don't exactly understand what to do, you're going to be able to figure it out because you know all the fundamentals. And that's why I'm so excited to share with you this framework today. And so the way that this framework works is that we are going to break everything down into three steps. And before we get into the framework, I want you to think about something for a second. What is actually the difference between data structures and algorithms? Right? We always talk about these basically as one thing, right? We talk about them as a cohesive unit where we say, I'm going to study data structures and algorithms. I'm going to study DS and algos, right? We always combine these, but the fact of the matter is that they're not actually the same thing. Right, like a data structure is literally how we structure the data, how we store it in memory. Whereas an algorithm is something that we're doing to operate on that data. And so as we're studying these, I want you to start thinking about how we can break these out. And I want to give you this framework of the three concentric circles that you can use as you're preparing. And so when you're preparing, you want to start with the core data structure. This is in the center of our circle. This is in our innermost circle. And you're gonna start with just that core data structure. That means, like, let's say that we were talking about lists. You would understand like what a list is. You would understand how that data is arranged. You would understand what the classes look like, how everything is actually structured and how that's stored. This is the innermost section, because without knowing that, we don't know how to operate on that. We don't know how to do anything with it until we understand that data. And so a great thing to do at this stage would be, if you're practicing a specific data structure and algorithm, implement the data structure, right? Like write a function that's going to actually take in some data and implement it. Write a function that's going to generate a tree from your data. Write a function that's going to generate a linked list and actually create that data structure. So this is the innermost circle. And once we understand how the data structure, how the data is actually structured, and once we understand how to implement that, now we move one step out and we move to our core patterns. And also, by the way, if you're liking these video editing skills, because I'm getting really fancy with this, definitely hit the like button down below, because that really helps with the video. So we move out to this second circle, which is our core patterns, right? And so once we've implemented our data structure itself, we're gonna move one layer out into the core patterns. And these are where we start to get interesting. The core patterns are really those like key algorithms that you need to know related to a given data structure. And so a great place to figure out what those core algorithms are is to look up the standard implementation of a specific data structure. So like, for example, with Java, you might look up what is the list interface if you're implementing a list, right? Because it's gonna show you that there are things like adding a node to a list, removing a node from a list, reversing the list, getting the nth element of the list. All of these different things are sort of core to that data structure, right? Those are the core algorithms that you wanna be thinking about with that data structure, and that's where you're going to start when you are implementing the data structure and when you're learning this data structure. You wanna move out to what are the core algorithms, because this is really what's gonna form the foundation for everything else. So let's consider an example again. If we had a linked list, we would have started by implementing the linked list as our data structure. And now we're going to look at what are all of those core patterns related to a linked list. We might want to be able to insert or remove an item from a linked list. We might want to be able to reverse a linked list or swap two nodes in a linked list or all of these sort of basic things. We might want to be able to get the length of a linked list or split a linked list in half. The list goes on and on, but these are all basically like the fundamental building blocks of things that we do with a linked list. And so what I want you to do when you get to this second level, once you know how to implement the data structure, you should implement all of these functions, right? Because the best way to learn, the best way to understand how this works is to actually go and implement it yourself. So the easiest way to do this when you're practicing a new data structure, create your own like class for that data structure, right? And start implementing all these functions and learn how they're implemented. With some of these data structures, even basic things are not that easy to do, right? Like with trees, you know, removing a node from a tree might sound like a relatively easy thing to do. It's a basic concept, but it's not as trivial in actuality because we have to figure out what the heck are we going to do with all the children. Right, and so the step two of learning the data structures and algorithms is to implement these core data structures, or these core algorithms, sorry. And then finally, we're gonna move out to the outermost ring. And this is where we start to get into the compound algorithms. And what that really just means is that these are algorithms that are composed of two or more core patterns, two or more of these simple algorithms, two or more of these basic pieces that are combining together to make something more complicated. And so this is where all or most of the questions that you're gonna get asked in your interview are actually gonna lie. They're all gonna be in this like outer circle where really all we're doing to solve the problems is we're just combining multiple different patterns. And so if we understand the patterns and we understand how to combine them together, it's basically like a puzzle. Right? At the end of the day, it's just a matter of combining them in some sort of creative way so that we can get to the solution that we want. And so like a perfect example of this is, let's say that I asked you to write a function that would print a linked list out in reverse order. Right? It's really easy to do this because all we have to do is combine a couple core patterns. So we could combine the core pattern of reversing a linked list with iterating over a linked list. And then all we have to do is we reverse the linked list, then we iterate over it and print it, and then we might want to reverse it back depending on whether we care about the data, right? So that would be like a really simple example of how we could do this, where we're just going to take those core patterns and we're going to do something with them. And the same is true with so many different problems. Like whenever you're approaching a problem, and especially whenever you're approaching a new problem that you haven't seen before, I would encourage you to think about, how do I take this problem and break it into smaller chunks, right? How do I break it into smaller core patterns? And by doing that, you're gonna see that so many different problems can be solved just by combining a series of core patterns. And so that's the way that this works. I really want you to start applying this framework because it's so valuable when you're thinking about how to approach these problems, to think about it in a structured way, right? And when you're thinking about data structures and algorithms in general, it's really important that you have a structured approach. And finally, I want to give you one more tip that you can use to figure out what you actually need to focus on. Right, because a lot of times there are so many different data structures and so many different algorithms that the question always becomes like, well, do I need to focus on this? Do I need to focus on that? Do I need to focus on red-black trees? Do I need to focus on priority queues? And the answer is, you want to start at the core and expand out. It's the same as this framework, right? You want to start with the most important algorithms and expand out from there. So if you have Cracking the Coding interview or you have Elements of Programming interviews, you can look at the table of contents and see like those are the core data structures and algorithms that you really need to understand. If you don't have the books, you can go on Amazon and just look at the table of contents on there. But that will give you that core set of data structures and algorithms that you need to know. So you can take those and apply this framework to that core set of data structures and algorithms. And then once you know those, you can start getting more creative. You can start expanding out from that core set to start understanding others. You can start implementing rebalancing trees. You can start implementing priority queues. And you can play around with different things. But if you don't understand those core data structures and those core algorithms first, then you're going to go into your interview and you're going to know all about a star search and you're going to know all about red black trees, but you're not going to be able to implement a simple linked list problem, right? And so the key with any interviews is focusing on the key parts first, focusing on the most reusable parts, and expanding from there. So that's all I got for you today. I hope you have a chance to apply this strategy. Let me know in the comments below what you think of this and how you're going to apply it. Let me know what data structure you're going to apply this to first. And if you enjoyed this video, definitely subscribe and give us a like below. And we also have our free 50 questions guide that you can download as well. And so I look forward to seeing you all in the next video.